So last week we speculated on how a China-designed Tesla might actually look like, and now we've got an official design sketch released by Tesla. And then an update on the Las Vegas Boring Tunnel project, because it's coming along nicely. And then many say Tesla's supercharger network is now getting competition, for example, by the Ionity chargers.
Turns out, they are brutally more expensive than Tesla's superchargers. And we also talked about the Porsche Taycan range of 201 miles. Turns out, the range of the Turbo S version is even worse. Then also a bit on the Lucid Air, which seems like a really interesting electric car. And a bit on the US energy mix. Because guess what? Coal is dying. Even Trump can't stop this trend. So stay tuned for these fascinating developments.
So only a few days after the release of our last EV video, where we speculated on how a China-designed Tesla might actually look like, a new design sketch has surfaced depicting a car which looks like kind of a smaller version of a Model 3. We know that Elon has been teasing that Tesla would want to release a sub-Model 3 car, which would be priced around the $25,000 range, for quite a while now. So this design sketch was actually released for a job posting for China's new Tesla design center. We're of course not sure if this design sketch will be indicative of the future, let's call it Model 2 design, because Elon said that we can expect a very radical and futuristic design, about the same level of radical design as the Cybertruck. The car in this sketch looks more standard, kind of like a smaller Model 3, so not really radical and futuristic. Therefore, we doubt that this will be the final design. However, we think that this is a confirmation that the car which Tesla will be producing in China will be a sub Model 3 sized car with a very attractive pricing, opening up Tesla to an even bigger potential customer base.
That way, even more people can experience the advantages of driving a Tesla, be it the free over-the-air updates, be it the autopilot, and in the near future, full self-driving, or be it the supercharger network. And how good the supercharger network actually is, not only coverage-wise, but also price-wise, shows the news here. How pricey the supercharger alternatives really are. The Ionity network, for example, has just released a new pricing, which is just absolutely insane. The price in Europe will be 79 euro cents per kilowatt hour. 79! That's more than twice the price of the superchargers in Europe, which is normally around 30 to 35 cents per kilowatt hour, and almost three times the supercharger price in the US. Now we really don't know which kind of drugs Ionity took before deciding on this price scheme, but it must have been some extremely strong stuff. Or, of course, they are getting paid by legacy car makers and our big oil in order to slow down EV adoption. Because with such a pricing, all other cars than Tesla will of course sell worse. Because everyone in Europe who wants to buy a non-Tesla will think how brutally expensive it is to own an electric car. With this kind of prices, you don't save anything anymore with an electric car compared to a diesel or gasoline car. And we think that's exactly what big oil and legacy car makers want. They always want to slow down EV adoption as much as possible. So either Ionity has been bought, or they are just completely crazy. Either way, this is some excellent news for Tesla. Because now, even more people will want to buy a Tesla, instead of a car from the so-called competition.
And the so-called competition? What is the so-called a competition doing, which as we know is only a competition by name? Well, it turns out they are continuing to fail and embarrass themselves all over the place. Now, if you thought that the Porsche Taycan base version with its 201 mile EPA range was quite bad already, then brace yourselves. Because the EPA rating of the Porsche Taycan Turbo S, which is the highest spec version, has now been released, and it's an even worse 192 miles. So yeah, you get half the range of the top-of-the-line Model S for double the price. Sounds like a good deal, right? Half the range, double the price. Porsche, 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 what are you doing? Now we think the Porsche Taycan Turbo S will probably sell like a maximum of 100 cars to absolute die-hard Porsche fans, like totally die-hard, over-the-top Porsche fans will buy it. Everyone else who has some kind of cost-to-value ratio feeling will choose a Tesla Model S Performance.
Another Tesla competitor, which might really deserve the name, should it ever really enter production, is the Lucid Air. Now, Lucid has announced that the real production version of the Lucid Air will be revealed in April, with production start by the end of 2020. Apparently, they really seem to be earnest this time, with plans of building their factory in Casa Grande in Arizona, where up to 2,000 people will be employed when the plant is finished in 2022. It indeed seems that clearing work on site has already begun. Now, if this would really happen, we'd be quite excited, because the Lucid Air really looks cool and futuristic, which we always like. And the specs sound quite a lot like the Model S. A 400-mile real-world range, under 2.5 seconds to 60 mph, and over 200 mph of maximum speed. That's at least what they claim. We shall see when the car comes out. Because remember what Porsche claimed of their range, and what Audi or Jaguar claimed of their ranges, and they all fall short of their claimed ranges under real-world conditions, as we know. So we shall see. And let's not forget that Faraday Future years ago was also announcing that they would soon start to build their factory in Nevada, which, as we know, never happened. But we really hope that we will be positively surprised and see the Lucid Air enter production in late 2020.
But there is a thing which we don't like so much about the company Lucid, and we also want to talk about that, even if it means we get a brutal shower of dislikes. Now, they are basically being almost entirely funded by a $1 billion investment of a Saudi Arabia technology fund, which they received about a year ago. That's right, a giant investment by Saudi Arabia. You know, Saudi Arabia, the country where there is the death penalty for homosexuality, or for blasphemy also, which can be already the mere criticism of Islam, by the way, or even for witchcraft. Yes, 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 there's the death penalty for witchcraft. Oh, you know, and also the country where the rights of women are, shall we say, not really respected so much, where women basically, one might even go as far as to say, have no rights at all. Yeah, exactly, that very open-minded and very tolerant country. Now, if they would be culturally and regarding religion only be as progressive as they seem to be regarding their investments, we'd be much more positive on Lucid. But of course, it's always morally a very difficult question if you should buy a product sponsored by a country that is not so friendly, you know? Because we really like the Lucid Air, it looks really futuristic and cool, and we think it has some amazing features. So we don't want to see this car fail, actually. But will we support Lucid? Probably not. We will probably stick to Tesla, because Tesla are the first ones, they started the EV revolution, and that's why we always will continue to support Tesla.
So now back to some non-controversial topics, before we get too many dislikes for this video. The Boring Company Tunnel in Las Vegas seems to be indeed progressing, with new photos of the interior being revealed. Apparently, the tunnel is now 50% completed, and will be in the first stage situated to connect the two ends of the Las Vegas Convention Center. But later, it will be expanded to also connect to the Strip, maybe even to the airport one day. We are really happy to see the Boring Tunnels expanding and cannot wait to see them in action. Hopefully, we will also see those passenger pods, which were shown in the early Boring Company animations, being able to use the tunnel system. It would be really cool to get from one end of the convention center to the other in such a pod by the end of this year. we will know at CES 2021 at the latest, because that's when the tunnel system will be open according to Elon. In other positive news, coal plants are slowly dying and continuing their decline, as new data from the US Energy Information Administration shows. While of course renewables are continuing their growth. 51% of all retirement in the energy sector will be coal plants in 2020, while 76% of the new installations will be either solar or wind.
Well, technological progress cannot be stopped, not even by Trump himself. All that he can really do is to merely delay the inevitable death of coal, oil, and other fossil fuel-based energy creation methods, as they will be slowly replaced by renewable energy. And that is highly needed, because we are now at a mind-boggling 1.1 degrees Celsius above pre-industrial levels, as the latest NASA measurements show, with the 5 warmest years on record since weather recordings began in 1880 having all been the years since 2015. Yes. So 2015 to 2019 were all the warmest years on record so far, and this trend isn't stopping. But hey, it's only 1 degree. Why are you making such a drama out of this? 1 degree? Are you kidding me? This is not a lot, right? Stop being such an alarmist. You climate radical. You eco berserk. Yes, but don't forget that the average temperature of Earth in pre-industrial times has been 15 degrees Celsius. So an increase to 16.1 degrees Celsius already represents an increase by 7%. 7%. Now 7% still, 7%, that's not much. Okay, please give me 7% of all your money. You still think 7% isn't so much? So yeah, 7% in 140 years. This is quite bad. But the Earth already witnessed such increases in temperature quite a few times. Yes, that's true, it did. And then 90 freaking percent of all life died on this planet. But this is certainly not man-made. This is just Earth. This is Earth doing some random stuff. It has nothing to do with us. Nothing. Well, unfortunately, science and physics speaks another language. There's a 5 sigma certainty that global warming is man-made. 5 sigma. You know what that means? This means that there's only a 1 in a million chance that global warming is not man-made, and this is just a statistical anomaly which we just by chance happen to witness right now. Therefore, we'd say it's about freaking time that fossil fuels are being destroyed. Sorry. And this, by the way, means that the energy mix in the US will continue to become cleaner and cleaner, so that EVs, which even now emit far less CO2 than diesel or gasoline cars, see this video here where we did some calculations showing just how much less CO2 electric cars actually emit even in the US energy mix. And so electric cars will continue to emit even less and less CO2 in the coming years and coming decades, as the world is shifting completely to renewable energies. Until at some point in the next decades, we think it will be around the year 2040, 2050 at the latest, humanity will have become completely carbon neutral. And this will be an amazing day.
So what do you think about the insane pricing of Ionity in Europe?
It's...
Did they just go completely crazy, or are they secretly sponsored by Big Oil or legacy car makers to slow down EV adoption? And do you think that we are too harsh on Lucid, even though they are backed by Saudi Arabia?
We are very certain you will let us know your opinion in very colorful language in the comment section afterwards, where we are very glad to engage with you as always.
And it really means a lot to us if you would give this video a share, a like, or also a dislike.
What? How would you dislike this? This is wonderful. I would be extremely sad if you give it a dislike. I would cry, okay? Please don't do it. Cry.
So see you in the next episode.
See you next time.